English. When one is hungry, one has the right to choose the path for his bread. I chose English, but before I amputated the alphabets, I first listened through mother's voice that nourished early rhythms of my brain's thinking veins. Now my mother grows old, unable to console me, and my hunger is impossible to soothe. Nowadays, I only speak out of my hunger and proving myself being another victim of the lust that is not mine. Possessions. From my grandfather, the patience. From my father, the anger. From my mother, the forgiveness. And from my lover, the quest for love. I carry them like weapons in my possession, while fighting against the shamelessness of my country. Pochiram Kamde, the saga of Jai Bhim. Once upon a time when Marathwada was burning, Pocha asked the upper caste goons, "Will you say Jai Bhim?" Pochiram says, "Yes, I will, Jai Bhim." Pochiram's hands were chopped off. Pocha asked the upper caste goons, "Will you say Jai Bhim?" Pochiram says, "Yes, I will, Jai Bhim." Pochiram's legs were chopped off. Eventually, Pochiram died, upholding Jai Bhim, even at the cost of his life. Two generations. He has started his life with bone-crushing labor, from working at a cycle repairing shop to become a truck driver and satisfy the desires of many stomachs. His son started to write small stories about father's bone-crushing struggle as well as his forefathers. Those are only present within the rapturous veins of his imagination. Both of them today do not have any idea of each other's occupation. There is no word that can connect them but the crude silence between two generations. Dilemma. My father sang to me in a language his father taught him. Hence, in it, his rage had clarity, his love was sublime. But I grew up much greedy. I wrote in English and kept on writing. Later, father's word turned voiceless to me. I turned deaf to his song, I grew up mean. Today I imagine, if I have a son or a daughter, what song shall I sing to them? Precisely in what language shall I sing?